is changing, and that's how it's going to be. But life and its reasons hasn't changed, and that's how it's going to be. And if I know anything that life's been teaching me, telling you, from days to weeks, from weeks to months, from months to years, and from generations to generations, this is it. Until you die, you wake up. I don't know who you are, and I don't know what you got. But this I know, you got something, and you have something to live for. There is this passage in the scriptures that I love so much. It says, "For the Lord God has not caused it to rain upon the earth, because there was no man to wet the ground." If you're interested in where God is at, God is waiting for you to work. I see many want to get to the workstation of success without taking the wet bus, or that's what it be in the city of greatness without having a wet parent. You can't escape the wet. It is compulsion. It is the call. You want to make it, you work it. The only thing in this life that I know that you live is still full of shoes, the wet. We talk of Dr. Martin King, not because of his suit. We talk of Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, not because of his degrees, or Dr. Nelson Mandela, not because of the car he drove, nor the houses he built. We speak of them today, and they still live because of the work they did. That dreams that you got, that vision you have, that desire you feel, that idea that you got, ain't gonna be a reality without the work. We're all gonna die one day, but you gotta get wiped today. Because we don't wanna talk of how you left us. We wanna talk of what you left us with. Remember, people will identify you not by name, not by work. So until you die, you're working.